Well, providers of online meeting and event hosting platforms have been making a killing as the COVID-19 changes the way people interact. Grace Foods will be using one of these facilities to stage its first ever virtual jerk fest on Saturday, August 8th. The event will feature some huge names in the entertainment business, talking about Jacure, Beanie Man, Allison Hynes, and Lila Aiki. From today until event day, the Sports Mag Zone will be talking to these stars as we build up to the event. And we begin with a man who hails from Jamaica's West End, Hanover Parish to be precise. His is a distinctive voice. He has recorded numerous hits and at birth was named Secretary Alcock by his mother. Sports Mag viewers, we welcome one of reggae's finest, Jacure. Jacure, are you there?
Yeah, brother. Give thanks, my brother. Greetings.
Greetings, man. Good. First of all, how have you been managing in this period? You've not been able to interact with the fans as usual. You've not been able to go out regularly to your studio and to vibe with your colleagues as usual. How have you been handling that?
Well, me and my own studio, so the studio is quarantined. Just me and my own colleagues. So that's the good part. But, you know, things and time have changed. So when it changes, happen with COVID coming, we just learn from news and Zoom we have to use, but still fans are get touch. Because, you know, them see what going through. People use up the internet more than any other time now because most people get time for, you know, stay home and look. So we use up like Instagram and, you know, this Zoom or whatever is there to be used. We just use it up at our advantage for make sure that we can still reach out to the fans in a virtual way.
Jacure, I know that you've always been a prolific songwriter. Have you made use of this downtime to full up your songbook?
Definitely. Yeah. One of my song right now, I'm finishing the album and I put together in the studio. I mean, I'm in the studio now. I want to walk inside and get a view. So I'm in the studio right now as we speak because I'm in Montego Bay. So whenever I'm going to use the studio, I have to stay down here for a week or two because I don't want to be back and forth too much.
What kind of vibe do you get from the West, Jacure? You're a West man, but you've traveled, of course, all over Jamaica and all over the world, but the West is particularly close to you and good to you. What kind of vibe do you get from Western Jamaica?
I'm not going to tell you a lie. Very interesting question, because when I come forward to the West, I get so much love. Sometimes I couldn't even believe because, you know, sometimes I'm not trying to fool on myself. So I'm out there sometimes, I don't remember how many I'm cure. Yeah, to be honest, there's some days I just live normal and I go through. But they love it. Sometimes my people remind me, and I said, Jano, from anywhere to Mobit, to Westmoreland, to Savlomar, to Negril, because I was born in Cascade, Hanover, grew up in Flankers, Montego Bay, all family and them youth are growing on my hand. No family father, I'm auntie, man, auntie them was in same class. So, but from maybe you go right back, the whole Western side, to be honest, I get a lot of love. Everyone show me love, maximum love.
Jacure, when we lost the signal with you, I was telling George and Lance that, you know, I genuinely love your music, especially Unconditional Love, because sometimes it makes people feel like they're in love even when they're not. But I want you to talk to us about this new song that you have. It's supposed to be the hottest for summer 2020, Rock the Boat. The storyline behind that song, tell me about it.
Well, you know, it's just a simple song of me and my writer sit down and come up with. It's just, you know, if she can rock the boat, then don't know, she have to rock it.
you have to explain, because we have so many different viewers, right? What do you mean by rock the boat, and what are you trying to tell the woman in that song?
Well, in the song, it's basically, I said, I'll be rocking with you, you know, so if you rock with me, let's rock the boat. So it's a me and you situation, baby, you get me?
Yeah.
So it's never one-sided.
understand. So this virtual concert, of course, this Grace Jerk Festival, how long are you going to be performing and how different will this be for you? Because, I mean, as George mentioned, you won't be able to touch the fans, you won't be able to get that energy from the fans. So what are your plans for that?
You know, when the little babies, them have them little fake kitchen and they make them...
Dolly house, yes.
So now, you have to learn to fake the audience and know that you're just looking at millions out there, but you can't see them.
And how long will you be performing for?
I'll be performing for like 4 to 5 minutes, and this is like my third, this is my second virtual show. I did one for Irie Jam, New York Radio, and I was supposed to do one for 97, but I think it's still in the making. I was to be on Sunfest, but you know, a lot of the deal doesn't go to right, so I'm gonna just fall through and leave it.
Yeah, Cure, we know that in the reggae business and the dancehall scene, sometimes the issue of longevity comes up. You've been a top flight performer now for well over a decade. How do you see yourself in the reggae landscape, wing the musical fans for decades upon decades? Because you have that sound that appears to me as if it will last for generations.
Thank you, because this is the thing. Me, Garnet Silk, to come with a sound, and even when him gone, him never will be forgotten, because that sound is unique. And what makes most artists unique in their own way is when you have your own sound and you don't sound alike. You know what I mean? And I came with one of them sounds, and I inspired a lot of artists. Like artists like Gypsy look at me and say, Jackie, you inspire me to sing. Warrior King, even people like what you call him, from Gentleman from Germany, look at me and said, Jackie, you are part of my inspiration. But some artists will tell you personally, and they won't write it in their bio. They don't have to, but as long as they've seen me and opened to me like that and said, yeah, you know, you are part of my inspiration, and you helped me in a certain way, I'm grateful, because it inspired me to know that even some artists on the scene, a whole lot of artists, my father is my brother, anyway, they know. Well, the first song I sing with my brother, sing back some of them, and my brother come to me all the time and say, you're one of my greatest inspiration as a singer, and I look up to my brother, respect him, even Cartel too. And, you know, I can name a few artists that let me know, so, yo, I give them a lot of inspiration, because I've been running a while, and sometimes I even need a check on the time span that I've been around so long.
Yeah.
But I put in a lot of work. We should be able to get me cross boundaries, and should I be able to get me inspiring a lot of people and lift up a lot of people across the globe. So we can't doubt the work that we put out, you know, because a lot of great work was done.
Yeah. Cure, well, just before I go to you with the last question, you mentioned a Gentleman from Germany. Some of you may be wondering who Gentleman is. He's the German guy who sang on the Drop Leaf Rhythm, arguably the best culture rhythm made in the history of dancehall. I still have my copy from Danger Zone, Jack Cure. I still have my Danger Zone CD with the Drop Leaf Rhythm.
That Drop Leaf Rhythm, I'm the first artist to came number one. I was in lockdown, but everywhere when I turned on my radio, I could hear myself on every station. And that's when I know that the song was seriously big.
Yep. Give me a piece of Only You again, Jackie. Give me a piece of Only You.
And
what
then
am
my
I
song.
Longing for? My baby to love me more. What am I longing for? No Babylon release to cure. You see me?
Jackie, you have to sing my song, though. You can't sing what George requested. Unconditional Love.
Listen to this. You never see this coming. Then the next thing you know, unconditional love. Unconditional love. You ain't looking for no diamond. Ain't digging for no gold. Just some. But it's love.
Wow.
Yep. Cure, I want to congratulate you. Looking forward to your performance. I note that Billboard, your Royal Soldier album spent 8 weeks there, peaked at number one. The second album you had to peak at number one on the Billboard charts, and you have several albums on the index. Congratulations to you.
So, you know, it's not bad. My last album was better than the Royal Soldier, but I'm still grateful. We have another album right now that I just finished, it's just being mixed. It's a 100% lover's album. It's just the first in my life I've ever been, put together like 10 songs together, just singing about pure love. So this is a new project for me, and the project will be called the Undeniable Cure.
Yeah. Undeniable Cure. Jack Cure, big respect to you, sir. And we look forward to you lighting up the Grace Virtual Jerk Festival, August 8th and 9th.
Thank you very much. And I hope everyone loved the performance, because I put my heart in it. So
thank you.
God bless
you.
And thanks for having me and the Sports Max, so the fans them can see. Because you know, I'm a soccer fanatic. You know, I'm a Messi fan. I'm a Barca fan. So I've watched Sportsmax three times, La Liga eight times.
There you go. I'll leave you with this.
I'm not supposed to go watch La Liga part more Sportsmax. So, you know, I'm showing into Sportsmax right through. So, big respect to Sportsmax. So, we can always get to see La Liga and see what's going on in the Spanish league. A Spanish league is my football.
There you go.
It's not an English league, but I'm a Spanish league.
As Vibes Carter said, Jackie, as we go.
Everybody know me is for the man who got to Barcelona. I do Barcelona over 15 times in a camp now, and I watch like over 5 classical live.
Wow. Wow. As Vibes Carter said, you have to be skinner than Messi's shoemaker.
Yeah, man. That's just me stuff. Me, I watch one with Messi. I'm a side of struggle, and Messi, I try to take up the whip by, you know, helping Barcelona to put his input. I hope everything can work.
Yeah, man. All right, Kira. Big up. Later.
Respect and thank you.
Good, good, good. And I forgot what I went for. Just as soon as you said hello.